And it's only right I say I'm out. Yeah. Shark Tank is probably all this money or the cars only parking. Woo. I've been eating good, stacking chips like a card game. Woo. Walk around knowing on the shit like a fart stand.
You have 100,000 views on your first day of releasing a song, and then it spreads from there. What up, Smart Rapper Gang? Now we're gonna talk about another music marketing secret. And this is pretty much is gonna be how you're able to get an enormous amount of views or streams or both on your music on the day of release, okay? And just so you do know, this, just like the other four videos that I've released, which are crazy secrets, you need to go check those out on the Smart Rapper channel. They're all music marketing. This is from week four of the Rapper Guide, which is a week by week, step by step, exactly what to do for your music career guide from start to be able to do everything. You'll have a fan base, everything, okay? You learn anything and everything you need to know. And this is one piece of that that's inside of the fan base formula in week four, okay? So just imagine. In the last video, we talked about retargeting ads, which if you watched that, should have blown your head into smithereens because I show you how you can turn anybody into a fan and how gaining a fan actually works. You need to go watch the video if you haven't, all right? That's also inside of the fan base formula, which you get in week four, okay? All these music marketing videos this week are from that. Imagine what you're getting through the whole rapper shortcut, I'm telling you. I'm just giving you videos from week four. Excited, but now, okay, let's get to it. We're talking about how to build your fan base properly, okay? You need to do this because if you wanna be able to always reach people who become fans or are potential fans, you don't wanna lose them forever. If somebody was like, oh, I might be a fan of this person, they hear your music, then they go away, but they'll never come back maybe, right? So you need to make sure that you can always capture something about that person. This way later, let's say that you don't even have music out yet, but 1,000 people but in the first 4 months of your career happen to click your Instagram bio and you didn't even know they ever even hit your Instagram bio link, okay? They click your bio link. Anybody who clicked the link, it saved them to a special list, okay? Now you have a list of 1,000 people who know your name, they've clicked your link. You didn't even know they hit your profile, okay? You can run ads targeting those exact 1,000 people. Hey, remember me? Yeah, you clicked my link 4 months ago. Check out my song though. Right? This is really powerful. Watch. You also want to make sure that even if they don't click your link, if you can get their email or their phone number or some type of information, you'll never have to pay to run a retargeting ad because you'll actually have direct contact information for them, which is free for you to use over and over again. For example, if you have 100,000 people on an email list and you have a new song come out and you send an email to 100,000 people on the list, which costs you no money, 100,000 people see your email, they open it, you have 100,000 views on your first day of releasing a song, and then it spreads from there. That's why having and collecting the data and the information of potential fans and people who are already fans is massively important. This will save you hundreds of thousands of dollars throughout your career, and eventually you'll be able to get 1 million views on first day of release. Now let's talk about why collecting fans' contact information is number one over them actually following you on any social media network. Got 100,000 subscribers on YouTube? So what? YouTube only shows your videos to less than 5% of your subscribers. Then if those 5% like it, it then shares it to another 5%. And so on and so on. That's why sometimes you see videos on my channel, you're like, yeah, you got 250,000 subscribers, but only 5% of people watched it. It's because it's an educational channel. People only click videos they're actually interested in watching. If I make a video about SoundCloud, but you don't care about SoundCloud, you're not gonna watch it. Okay? That's the difference. But if you watch a video about SoundCloud and then you click it, but it's not what you expect and you don't watch it, well then YouTube says, well, they weren't interested, so we're not gonna share it to more people.
What?
Right? That's the thing. If I made clickbaity videos and only talked about music artists, I was like, oh, why the new Drake album sucks or whatever. If I do that, every time I mention an artist's name in a video, the video skyrockets. That's why it's easy to build a channel like Blackie Speaks. No offense to Blackie Speaks, great channel. All right guys, I'm sorry I'm not wearing a shirt. I didn't wanna run all the way to my room on the other side of the place to get a shirt. But look, I'm editing the video right quick. And just to let you know, like I'm not hating or anything else like that, I just wanna show you as proof. If you look right here, this video that I released with J. Cole's, which is, I made it like drama, like look, oh, J. Cole's never gonna release another feature. When you do videos like this, it has 105,000 views. This video has more views than every video for the 2 months around it, okay? If all I did was make videos like that, I'd have 3 million subscribers. Because I know how to make them and I could just create drama. But that's proof that works, okay? So there you go. But that's why it's easier to do that as opposed to an educational channel where people only actually care about the specific thing that they're trying to learn at the moment. If I make a video on how to rap, but you already know how to rap, you're never gonna click the videos on how to rap, okay? And that affects me in the algorithm. So I could have 1 million subscribers, I'll still only be getting 50,000 to 100,000 views on a video if enough people click it, okay? And that brings me to my point with this, is that the social media platform where you're gaining fans, I have 250,000 subscribers plus, a smart rapper, I can't reach all 250,000 of those people, but I earned them subscribing to me. I earned that. I worked, released over 850 videos to get to the point where I had that many subscribers. It took me 4 years, okay? And I can't even reach all those people because YouTube controls it. Got 100,000 followers on Instagram? Well, Instagram only shows your post to less than 10% of people. The social media platforms completely control all of this, okay? Also, think about what happens if a social media platform deletes you if you have 100,000 subscribers or followers. And they delete you, what are you gonna do? You're screwed. You have no way to contact those people who followed you. They're changing the algorithms every day, so it's getting harder and harder for you to actually reach your own fans. But if you can start collecting contact information of your fans and followers, you own that information and you can contact them anytime you want. I'd rather have zero subscribers on SmartRapper and 250,000 people on my email list, because I would be getting at least 100,000 views on every video instead of 10 to 20,000 views on every video. You get where I'm coming from? Because I can actually reach the person. If YouTube showed every person on my YouTube channel, if they showed all 250,000 people my video, I would be getting 50,000 plus views every video I released. But they don't show it to every person. They show it to a small amount, and then they show them to a couple more. Man, I can't do anything about it. It makes you feel helpless. And I don't want you to ever have to feel like that. So from the very beginning, I want to let you know how essential it is and how important that you gain and get your fans' contact information, the email, their phone number, anything you can get that you have possession of. Because then you're not powerless. You own it. The social media does not, okay? Plus, consider this. Anybody who ever joins your email list or gives you their contact information is a real actual fan compared to somebody who just follows you on social media who would unfollow you anytime anyways, right? You want to build this email list because those are people who actually care enough to be contacted by you. Those are people who are actually going to want to hear your new song when it releases, okay? Think about that. This is very powerful.
Do it.
On top of the fact that if you have 1,000 people in an email list and you release a new t-shirt and you sell 50 t-shirts at 20 bucks each, you just made a grand, okay? Think about that. Off of one email, and you only sold 50 t-shirts out of one out of every 20 people, okay? For 20 bucks each, $1,000, like that. Only because you had the email list. In the Rapper Shortcut, I teach you how to set up all of this inside of the Dreamcatcher in the first month of the Rapper Shortcut, because I want you to have it set up. Because once it's set up, it's just set up. You don't gotta worry about it. And then anybody who ever goes to your profile is just being put into a list, and you're good. You can reach them and contact them later, okay? You ain't got the Rapper Shortcut yet. You need to go get your hands on it. It'll change your whole life. It'll change the whole game for you, okay? And if you want the calendar to see what the entire Rapper Shortcut's about, that's a free download below. Go ahead and get your hands on that. SmartRabbit.com/calendar, okay? I'm Rob Lovell. This is Smart Rabbit. This video's already long enough, all right. But you now understand that you need to be collecting that information. I'll show you how to do that in the Rapper Shortcut in week 4 with the Dreamcatcher, and you learn a lot more about it inside of the Fanbase Formula. They're both in week 4. You get stuff every week. I tell you, it's crazy, all right? Keep hustling, gang. Click those links below. I'll see you at the top.
And it's only right I say I'm out.
Yeah.
Shark Tank is probably all this money, or the cars only parking. Woo. I've been eating good, stacking chips like a card game. Woo. Walk around knowing on the shit like a fart stand.